Washington Avenue sidewalk replacement area under Wheeling and Lake Erie Bridge and adjacent sidewalk. Motion to Borough Council authorizing engineer sites to prepare specifications for the Washington Avenue sidewalk replacement for area under the Wheeling and Lake Erie Bridge and adjacent sidewalk in the railroad right of way, authorizing manager Collins to advertise the same. Total cost of the project estimated by engineer sites is $47,460. This includes both sides of Washington Avenue with the sidewalk located in the Wheeling and Lake Erie right of way.
So, did ever be against what we do to it?
Oh, no. They don't care what we do to it. They just, they're just telling me that they will do nothing to it. And as far as whatever we want to do, you know, it's fine.
We gotta do the work, they're not gonna come back to us and say, we want this changed.
They just said that they have too many of these areas. Their staff is cut down, they don't have people to do it, they don't have the, just like, it's the same example as I would make, like it's along the railroad station street there, where the railroad ties and things have been left and that type of thing. They sent some people off, they cleaned up a little bit, and getting things again, they left things in the right of way. It's almost impossible to deal with them, but as far as us wanting to do something, they're all for that. Just like the trestle, us painting the trestle, us fixing the walls of the trestle, they're all for that too, but they say, we don't just.
And in terms of sidewalk maintenance, that's kind of, you know, we have these all ordinances like everybody else that are chasing property and everybody else. The railroad right of ways is all over the country, cities, they are kind of different.
Well, the letter is, you can't make us do anything.
Well, and part of the reason behind that is because it really needs to see the property ownership and there's.
And it's just like, it sits there and it's nobody's property. In the meantime, you have people that are walking out onto the roadway in the dark, in the rain and in the ice because water lays there, so it's a dangerous situation. I mean, we could try to lease their property, we could try, we've cited them, and then we sent a citation to them as far as property maintenance goes, and we saw what we got back. So, you know, if there's any avenue to try to get our money back later, but I think.
It's our responsibility.
Right now, for our residents, yeah.
Is that, how often is it re-inspected, is it safe?
It's safe, they actually, we just redid the decking about 6 months ago. So that's, and they did come, they could, if you notice, those little plastic tops there to try to stop some of the water that didn't work. But I stood down there with them and, you know, we took a look at it, stood in the water and pretty much said.
Did you get a socks wet? Hopefully you got a socks wet.
Tell PennDOT, and you know, PennDOT's not gonna fix the sidewalk in the railroad right of way, so.
Does it sound like it's PennDOT?
Yeah, it does. But they've already, you know. They actually were going to help us.
PennDOT?
Yes. If we had an ADA compliant project with the Washington Avenue reconstruction, but because all of our sidewalks were already done and they were already ADA compliant, they were going to try to put that on the back end of it and help us. But then there's nothing ADA compliant that they have to do up there. So then they said, you know what, we can't help you with it. So I was hopeful all last year that they were going to come in and help, and at the 12th hour, there's no ADA project, so this will be simple.
I'd like to, over some period of time, have your legal opinion regarding looking at the PUC with this, Public Utility Commission. I don't know if this is a maintenance issue that the PUC may have oversight over. I'm not expecting to have an answer this evening. I'm not looking for you to put anything on the table, but I would like to take a look at it over the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, sure. Yes, I'm talking about that.
That's fine.
Sure.
The second item regarding the scope of the project, there's an area where there's no sidewalk left at all, okay? And then there's an area where the sidewalk is in disrepair. I don't know how, I can't in my mind's eye figure out how far back this scope is.
From, if you're coming from Great Southern Shopping Center, mm-hmm. and you're driving toward us, okay? Mm-hmm. You start at the railroad trestle on the right-hand side because the property owner actually fixed his sidewalk right. to that. So it's all that under there, and then all up in front of our Welch's because okay. that's all railroad.
All the way to the old railroad building?
Yes.
So
yes.
the old railroad building,
it stops there.
It stops there.
I think it's okay, on the other side is the trestle area, and then you come through, and the entrance of DNC Supply, all of their signs, everything, that's all railroad right of way. So it stops at the, it used to be the old E&A or E&A major, but
yeah, okay.
it stops there on that side.
So would you go in front of the old, what you're saying is the major?
The DNC Supply entrance. Uh-huh. That's right. It stops at the entrance there.
So it stops before the entrance. Because the entrance is open every time. Has it?
No.
Oh, you know what? They just did the.
They did the store there.
It'll stop right there. The rest is Fleet Depot's going in.
Right. Here's my thought, is that I don't know how much each side is, but it's the Don Wall, it's the Don Wall side, and not in front of his property either. It's really a difficult area.
Yeah.
It seems fairly clear that this community is going to pay to fix this. We might fight.
Give us 2 minutes, we'll get there.
Yeah, we might fight.
Yes, Joel.
No, what I'm saying is that if council were to do it,
yeah.
and clearly you're looking for the railroad to participate,
right.
but the odds of them soliciting McDermott can come up with something brilliant.
That's what we said the last month came.
Yeah.
She was going to formally cite them, and then he's like, Larry said.
Yeah. What my thought is, that maybe just doing the one side might be sufficient.
No.
That would go. No? Go ahead, Phil.
Why don't we take a ride up to the DOT place up there, or behind the high school, approach someone up there from the Department of Transportation of Pennsylvania, see if they can get us in touch with someone who's on a committee in Washington, D.C., representative, and see if they can come on and take a look at it. Because if we put pressure on them that way, they're going to say, this shouldn't be like that. If you go up there and get in their face, they're going to do something about it. Just call them.
We sent you.
They've already sent us.
Get on the phone.
We could actually get, have the state representative try to help us retrieve something, but the question right now is how long we go to leave it in.
Yeah, that's.
I am entirely supportive of the borough taking this action and repairing the sidewalk. I'm supportive of that.
Yeah, and then okay? trying to
get it back.
Right.
Did anybody make a motion?
So moved.
Very good. Also, Joel Anderson, Bruce Gallarducci, all those in favor?
Aye.